Good morning dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So as we know that we are discussing our biology lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Living world. Okay, in this living world we are going to discuss or we are discussing about the characteristics of living organism. Already we have discussed some characteristics, so let's move for the further characteristics of a living thing. So today we are going to discuss about one of the important characteristics of living organism, that is what? Excretion. Okay, now what is meant by excretion? So each and every living organisms are performing a certain life processes. Okay, so many processes are going on in our body. While these processes are taking place in our body also releases excretory products, or we can say that what? Waste products. Okay, and it is very necessary to throw out that waste products from our body, and that process is only called as what? Excretion. Okay, so for example we can say that whenever we are having the food, that food get digested. From the digested food we get the energy, but from all that food we are not getting the energy. Some food is remain as a undigested food, which is a waste material that we have to throw out from our body. Also from the various processes are taking place in our body, that from that process also the excretory products comes out. For example, we can say whenever we are doing the breathing process and the respiration process, carbon dioxide gas coming out or get released from our body. Okay, also our body produces some waste material like urine, sweat and the solid feces. Okay, so all these are the waste material that we have to throw out from our body. And the process, okay, the process of removal of the waste materials by an organism from its body is called excretion. Okay, so the removing of the waste materials by an organism from its body is called what? Excretion. That process is called as what? Excretion. So each and every living organism is doing the excretion. If we talk about the human being, then the human being can throw out the undigested food with the help of the anus. Also urine from the urinary opening or from the urethra. Okay, also we are throwing out the sweat with the help of our skin. Okay, so in this way all these are the waste material, and that waste material we are throwing out from the different excretory organs. Okay, so this is about the human being. If we talk about the plants, then plants also release some excretory products. Okay, for example we can say that plants are doing so many processes in themselves. They also release the carbon dioxide, okay, whenever they are doing the respiration process. Next one is the also the unwanted material in the plant gets stored into the leaf. Okay, and after the certain period of the time that leaf get shed down or that leaf get dropped down, that is only we are calling as what? Excretion. Also there are the some plants which release or which secretes the excretory products in the form of gums and resins. For example, see in the image, for example we can say babool is there or the drumstick is there. On that plant we can say the brown color sticky substance. Okay, so that brown color sticky substance is nothing but what? Gum or resin, which is a one type of the excretory products in the plants. Okay, so this is about the excretion in the plant. Also we can explain these or we can prove these, that plants can do the excretion process. That activity you have to try at your home. If you are having the potted plant, then cover the two or three leaves of the potted plant with the polythene bag. You can tie that polythene bag over the leaf and keep as it is for 7 to 8 hours. Okay, and whenever you will observe after the 7 to 8 years, then see here in the image on that polythene bag we can see the droplets of the water. Okay, that is nothing but what? Water vapors which get released during the process of which are going on in the plants. Okay, so in this way water vapors are the excretory products, we can say, or the throw out the extra water in the form of water vapor in the plants. Okay, so this is about what? Excretion in the plants and animals. Okay, now we will move for the next one characteristic, that is nothing but respond to stimuli. Now respond to stimuli means what? If someone prick the pin in your hand, and what you will do? Yes, obviously you will take your hands back very quickly. Okay, or you will try to avoid that pinching in your pricking. Okay, we will try to avoid that pricking, we can say that. So what you have done, that you have given the response to the certain action. Okay, one more thing I will tell you, that if your favorite food comes in front of you, then your mouth starts watering. That is also what response you are giving to the some actions. Okay, so respond to the stimuli. Now what is mean by the stimuli? Stimulus is any change in the surrounding of an organism to which it respond. Okay, so see here, if the food comes in your front, okay, that is what stimuli. Okay, and your mouth starts watering, that is what respond. Okay, that we are giving the respond to the stimuli. So each and every living thing is giving the respond to the stimuli. Okay, so human beings, animals are giving, but along with the human beings and animals, plants are also giving the respond to the stimuli. For example, do you know this mimosa plant or touch me not plant? Then what happened? When we touch that plant, then that plant close the leaves. Then all the leaves they trying to close. That is only we are calling what respond to the stimuli. Okay. One more example I will give. If the bell will ring, then we will get up and we will go to open the door. So the bell means what? Stimuli or stimulus. And we get up and we go there to open the door. That is what response. That is what response. Okay, so in this way each and every living being is giving the response to the stimuli. For example, whenever there is a summer season, then we are wearing the woolen clothes. That only we are giving the response to the different summer different seasons. Okay, so that is, that process is called as what? Respond to stimuli. Each and every living organism is giving response to the stimuli. Okay, so what stimulus is? Any change in the surrounding of an organism to which it respond. Okay, to which it respond means each and every living organism is giving the response to the stimuli, and that is only called as what stimuli. Okay, or that is only called as what stimulus. Okay, so you have to keep the two things in your mind which are very important, that are stimulus and response. What is mean by the stimulus? The pricking of the pin. That is what stimulus, and you take your hands back. That is what response. Okay, next one is that if the bell will ring and then you go to open the door, okay, then what ringing of the bell is what stimulus, while you open the door, that is what response. Okay, one more example. See, whenever there is a evening time, then the street lights get light up. Okay, and once it get light up, so many insects get attracted towards to the light. Okay, so the lightning of that lamp, it is what stimulus. All the insect runs towards the light, that is what response. Okay, so in this way we can say that each and every living organism is giving the response to the stimulus. Okay, if you touch to the hot pan, then you take your hands suddenly back. So touching to the hot pan, that is what stimulus. Taking your hand back, that is what your response. Okay, each and every living thing is response to the stimuli. Now the next one we are going to discuss about the next characteristics, that is nothing but what movement. Okay, so all the living things are showing the movement, whether it is animal, plant or human being. So what is mean by the movement? So to change the place, okay, or why the animals or the living things are showing the movement, there are so many different reasons. For that reasons they are showing the movement. For example, we can say that what to search the food, in the search of the shelter food. Okay, also to protect themselves from their enemies. Okay, so these are the certain reasons. For that reasons the animals are showing the movement. But my dear student, there is a little much difference between the movement and next one is, that is what locomotion. Okay, what locomotion. Let's see locomotion. Okay, so now locomotion means what? Changing the place. Okay, move from the one place to another place, that is called as what locomotion. Okay, so if I am standing now here, if I walk and if I change my place, then now I have done the Locomotion. I have done the locomotion. Okay. So what is meant by the locomotion? Changing the place from one place to another. Okay. We means whole body change the place. Now my body is standing here, but now I am walking. My whole body comes now on the another place. That process is called as what? Locomotion. Okay. And what is meant by the movement? Movement is what? The change in the some body organs, okay, or the movement of only just body organs. If I blink my eyes, then what I have done? I have done the movement. If I move my hand, then what I have done? I have done the movement. Because when I am moving my hand, my whole body is not changing the place. Only my certain organs are changing their place. Then it is called as what? Movement. Okay, so the movement and locomotion is little different. So what we can say, each and every living organisms are move and they are showing the locomotion. Okay, that is only called as what? Locomotion. So for every organism there is a different locomotory organ. Now locomotory organ is what? The organ that they use to do the locomotion. For example, all the terrestrial organisms, okay, for example, lion, giraffe, tiger, human being, dog, cat, they use their legs to move from one place to another place. It means what is their locomotory organ? That is what? Legs. Okay, legs are their locomotory organ. Okay, we will talk about the fish. Fish is living in the water. And what they use to move or to do the locomotion? Their fins. With the help of the fins, they can move from one place to another place. Next one, if we talk about the birds, then what the birds are using? They are using their wings. Okay, so they are using their wings to do the locomotion. It means what? Wings are their locomotory organ. Okay, so in this way we can say that each and every organism are having the different locomotory organ to do the locomotion. So see, like that we are a living organism, but plants are also the living organism. But the very important thing is that what? The plants are fixed under the ground. They cannot change their place. But still the plants are showing some movement. As we know that sunflower. Sunflower is trying to keep their face towards the sun. As the sun changes its position in the sky, sunflower is also changing their position. They are always trying to face the sunlight. Okay, so leaves on the branches are arranged like that, that each and every leaves will get the proper sunlight. Okay, so in this way what we can say that the plants are also showing the movement. Okay, the plants are also showing the movement, or the plants also do the some types of the movement in their different parts. But my dear students, there are the some non-living things are also there. For example, we can say the clouds, sun, moon, they are also moving. It means what? They are the living things? No, they are not a living thing. They are moving because of the certain external energy. Our vehicle is also moving. Okay, it can also go from one place to another place. Then is it a living thing? No. Why the vehicles we are moving? Because we are trying to move them. We move them from the one place to another place. Some external energy requires to move them. So they are what? They are non-living thing. But still they can move with the external energy. Okay, so only the living things, human beings, plants and animals can show the locomotion and the movement. Okay, now we move for the next characteristics, that is what? Reproduction. So after the certain age of the life, each and every living organism produce the young one of their own kind. Okay, dog gives the birth to the puppy, cat gives the birth to the kitten, cow gives the birth to the calf. In this way, each and every organism gives the birth to their young ones. Okay, but only the difference is that what? Some are the organisms, those who gives the birth to their young ones directly, they are called as what? Viviparous, that we have already seen. Okay, and there are the certain organisms, those who lay first eggs, and from that eggs the young ones come out. Okay, and which are called as what? Oviparous. Okay, which is called as what? Oviparous. Viviparous directly gives the birth. Oviparous use the eggs, and from that eggs the new one or the young ones come out. Okay, like us, plants also reproduce. As we know, the if you want to reproduce the plant, then we have to sow the seed in the soil. Then that seed get germinate, and that seed get convert into the slowly a new plant. Okay, but there are some plants in that different parts of the plants are used to reproduce. For example, we can say bryophyllum. So with the help of that leaf, we can produce the new plant. Okay. Some roots are there, some stems are there. With the help of that parts, we can grow the new plants. Okay. So in this way, we can say that the plants can reproduce with the help of the seed and with the help of the some vegetative parts like roots, stem, and the leaves. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the characteristics of excretion, respond to stimuli, movement, and reproduction. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video, next point. And for today, thank you.